Haemophilus influenzae. Morphology. They are small gram-negative bacilli which are non-motile and non-sporing. They are pleomorphic. That is, they occur in different shapes. In sputum, they are seen as clusters of coccobacillary forms. And in sample of cerebrospinal fluid, they are seen as long bacillary and filamentous forms. The Haemophilus influenzae is a small gram-negative bacillus which is non-motile and non-sporing. It is pleomorphic. In sputum, they appear as clusters of coccobacillary forms, and in cerebrospinal fluid, they appear as long bacillary and filamentous forms. Coming to its antigenic properties, there are three main surface antigens. They are capsular polysaccharide, outer membrane protein antigen, OMP, and lipooligosaccharides, LOS. These are the three main surface antigens. We'll see about the capsular polysaccharide in detail. Capsular polysaccharide. The type B capsular polysaccharide has a unique chemical structure, which is made up of pentose sugars, ribose, and ribitol. Instead of hexoses and hexosamines as in the other five serotypes. So the type B Haemophilus influenzae has unique chemical structure which consists of pentose sugars. The capsular polyribosyl ribitol phosphate antigen, PRP, which is polyribosyl ribitol phosphate, which is present in Haemophilus influenza type B. It induces immunoglobulin G, immunoglobulin M, and immunoglobulin A antibodies, which are bactericidal, opsonic, and protective. So the capsular PRP antigen of Haemophilus influenzae type B induces immunoglobulin G, M, and A antibodies, which are bactericidal, opsonic, and protective. Haemophilus influenzae strains which are lacking a capsule are called as non-typeable strains. So few of the strains are non-typeable. Pathogenicity. Haemophilus influenzae is exclusively a human pathogen. It produces two types of infections, by invasive or by non-invasive. Invasive pathogenicity. Here the bacillus is itself the primary pathogen which causes acute invasive infections. In non-invasive, the bacillus spreads by local invasion along the mucosal surfaces. So it thereby causes secondary or superadded infections, usually respiratory tract infections. In invasive, the bacillus spreads by blood and they are protected from phagocytosis by their capsule. The most important infection caused by invasive type is Haemophilus meningitis. Whereas in non-invasive, the infections include otitis media, sinusitis, exacerbations of chronic bronchitis and bronchiectasis. The other diseases caused by invasive is laryngoepiglottis, conjunctivitis, bacteremia, pneumonia, arthritis, and pericarditis. The invasive pathogenesis occurs most commonly in children, and it is most commonly by type B Haemophilus influenzae. Whereas non-invasive is most common in adults, and it is commonly caused by non-capsulated strains. This is about the pathogenicity of Haemophilus influenzae. Now coming to the clinical presentation. First, meningitis. This is the most serious disease caused by Haemophilus influenzae, in which the mortality is up to 90%. The bacillus enters the meninges from the nasopharynx through the bloodstream and thereby causes meningitis, which is inflammation of the meninges. This most commonly occurs in children in the age group of 2 months to 3 years. Next is laryngo epiglottitis, which is acute inflammation of epiglottis with obstructive laryngitis. So it got its name laryngoepiglottitis, acute inflammation of epiglottis with obstructive laryngitis. This is seen in children more than 2 years of age. If untreated, this is fatal within hours, and tracheostomy is performed to relieve obstruction by the enlarged uvula. So here the uvula is enlarged, leading to the obstruction of the trachea. So tracheostomy is performed. The laryngoepiglottitis is always associated with bacteremia. Third is pneumonia. Pneumonia occurs in infants. It is accompanied by empyema and sometimes also with meningitis. In older children and adults, lobar pneumonia occurs, which is primary infection due to capsulated strains. Bronchopneumonia may occur as secondary infection with non-capsulated strains. So lobar pneumonia occurs as primary infection due to capsulated strains like type B Haemophilus influenzae, and bronchopneumonia may occur as secondary infection with non-capsulated strains. And the fourth is suppurative lesions. It is pus forming lesions like arthritis, endocarditis, pericarditis. These result from hematogenous dissemination. Otitis media can occur by direct spread from nasopharynx, and there's buccal and periorbital cellulitis in young children. The fifth and the last is bronchitis. The Haemophilus influenzae is associated with pneumococci, and they cause acute exacerbation of chronic bronchitis and bronchiectasis. So Haemophilus influenzae is also responsible for acute exacerbations of chronic bronchitis and bronchiectasis. Let's now see the lab diagnosis of Haemophilus influenzae. First, collection of specimen, which includes cerebrospinal fluid, blood or sputum depending on the site of infection. Second is microscopy. In case of meningitis, pleomorphic gram-negative bacilli are visualized under microscope in cerebrospinal fluid. Third is direct antigen detection. The CSF is detected in case of meningitis and urine in case of systemic infection. The direct antigen detection is performed by latex particle agglutination test. Fourth is culture, performed using cerebrospinal fluid. Culture can be performed on chocolate agar, blood agar with Staphylococcus aureus streaked across the plate. So this is a plate of blood agar in which Staphylococcus aureus is streaked across the plate. When Staphylococcus aureus is streaked across a plate of blood agar on which a specimen containing Haemophilus influenzae has been inoculated, after overnight incubation, the colonies of Haemophilus influenzae will be large and well developed along the side, the streak of Staphylococcus, and smaller farther away. So along the Staphylococcus aureus, the colonies are larger and they decrease in size farther away. These are the colonies of Haemophilus influenzae, and this phenomenon is called satellitism. Next, culture can also be performed on Levinthal's medium, in which the capsulated strains produce translucent colonies with distinctive iridescence. In Fildes agar, it is best for primary isolation of Haemophilus influenzae, which gives copious growth of the bacillus. Blood cultures are positive in case of laryngoepiglottitis and pneumonia. Biochemical reactions. The Haemophilus influenzae ferments glucose and xylose with acid production. But lactose, sucrose and mannitol are not fermented. So only glucose and xylose are fermented by Haemophilus influenzae. It shows catalase positive, oxidase positive, and the nitrates are reduced to nitrites. So nitrate reduction is positive. The treatment. Drug of choice for the treatment of Haemophilus meningitis is cefotaxime or ceftazidime. The drug of choice for Haemophilus meningitis is cefotaxime or ceftazidime. For respiratory infections, initially ampicillin and cotrimoxazole were used, but later plasmid-borne resistance has developed against them. So now the drug of choice for respiratory infections caused by Haemophilus influenzae are amoxicillin-cavulanic acid combination or clarithromycin. This is the treatment of Haemophilus influenzae. Finally, coming to the prevention. Prevention is done by active immunization with HIB-PRP vaccine, which is Haemophilus influenzae type B polyribosyl ribitol phosphate vaccine. The purified PRP is immunogenic in older children and adults. Older children more than 2 years of age and adults. But in children, the purified PRP is itself less immunogenic. So, it is coupled with protein carriers like diphtheria, tetanus toxoid or meningococcus outer membrane protein. So, this vaccine is called conjugate vaccine. This is given to improve the immunogenicity. So for children less than 2 years of age, conjugate vaccine is given. Rifampicin is given for 4 days to prevent secondary infection in contacts and also to eradicate the carrier state. So for treatment of secondary infection in contacts or eradication of carrier state, rifampicin is given for 4 days. This is the prevention of Haemophilus influenzae infection. That is all about Haemophilus influenzae. Thank you.